So we just looked at an argument for the surprising conclusion that death isn't bad for you. But what exactly is an argument? If you watch the Monty Python clip on YouTube, you know it's not just contradiction. It's not just two people yelling at each other. In fact, a much better definition is the one from the clip. An argument is a collective series of statements to establish a definite proposition. So in philosophy, we think of an argument as a sequence of claims, the last of which is the conclusion, and the earlier ones are premises of the argument. We're interested in deductive arguments that attempt to prove their conclusions, and we're going to look at two properties that those arguments might have, validity and soundness. Now, in ordinary life, valid and sound can be used as general terms of praise for ideas, theories, suggestions. In this course, we're going to use them quite specifically with quite precise definitions. They're terms that apply to and only to arguments, and they're terms for specific ways in which arguments can be good. To say that an argument is valid is to say that the conclusion follows from the premises, in that it's impossible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false. It doesn't matter whether the premises are in fact true. What matters is whether it's possible for them to be true and yet the conclusion false all the same. So here's an example of a valid argument. Premise one, Socrates is a cat. Premise two, all cats are mortal. Conclusion, Socrates is mortal. It's a valid argument because it's impossible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false. Conclusion follows from the premises. Here's an example of an invalid argument. Premise one, if Mina's taking this course, Mina is learning about ethics. Premise two, Mina is learning about ethics. Conclusion, Mina is taking this course. That's not a valid argument, because it's possible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false. It's true that if Mina's taking this course, she's learning about ethics. And it may be true that Mina's learning about ethics, but those could both be true even though Mina isn't taking this course. Maybe she's separately reading Plato's dialogues and has never even heard of the course. The conclusion doesn't follow from the premises, because it's possible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false, and that's why the argument is invalid.